lot of time on Sunday, Monday, just trying to figure out, you know, who's gonna play. You know, we're decimated by injuries, which again, there's no excuses. I never had one in my life, so you got to find a way to get it done. But I've never seen anything like it, and it continues to get worse. But you know, we'll see how the kids respond. We had a great visit on Sunday, thought it went well. We got beat by good. We didn't play very well, but we got beat by a good football team. I think by far the best team we played, certainly physically. And they got a great chance to win out if they play at the level they're playing at right now. But in the Big 12, you don't know, because you go next week and something else could happen, you know. And, you know, Kansas beat Texas. So, you know, it's one of those things. You just better be ready to line up and play. And, you know, so the best thing we can do is have a short-term memory, like I call it, forget it's over with, it's done with. And we got to get back on track, and we got to find a way to beat Kansas, and then you're playing for something. So that's kind of where it's at. So I'll take any questions, and try to keep you not in here long so you don't freeze to death.
Coach Kill, you mentioned the injuries. I'll ask again, any update on Zach or some of the running backs, as well as the quarterback situation?
Well, none of these are Zach. I was told today that where he's at is about 80%. So he is healing, but 80% is not 100%. And so, right now, I would say probably not. And hopefully, when we go to Iowa State, that we have him. But that's the report that we received. Right now, we don't have a running back that's healthy, and Amari won't practice today. The Watkins kid, you know, he's gonna get a lot of reps, you know, in practice, and we just gotta do what we gotta do. And the quarterback is Chandler got hurt, Sam dislocated his shoulder, our starter and Max, our leader. You know, he got a broken bone in his foot. So we're in a situation where, we've got to be able to get them healthy, and practice may be limited on what they can do, and we'll just do what they can do. And, I think, Chandler, he's got a chance to play, and Max has got a chance to play. And Sam's probably, we just have to see him. He's got a separated shoulder. He's on the doctor today. So that's where we're at. And so in those areas, we're hoping we get Kendrick back. And he's gonna practice today. And, he'll be in a red shirt. I think Amari will play, but we won't know that until probably Wednesday or Thursday. And if we can get Kendrick back, that would be a big deal for us. So he's got a chance to do that. So, if we can pick up one, that would be a big deal. Picked up two, that'd be great. And then the young kid that went in there, he didn't do bad, for not knowing anything. And maybe we're coaching too hard. Maybe we just don't tell him anything. He's let him play. I don't know, but. No, he did a good job. He worked hard to, give our running back coach credit. He had to get the kids ready in 3 days. So,
sure. How's the dynamic of a week change, though? When you guys are coming off such a tough performance, and you're playing a team that's coming off probably their biggest performance in a long time, and has a little momentum going?
Well, I think it's one of those things that, again, it's our job to get that done. It's my job. And with the internship going on, who's going to be the next head coach? There's a lot of distractions going on, but it's unique for me, and it's unique for anybody standing in the situation, because they used to not get rid of head coach until the end of the year, and now you get all these intern coaches all over the place because Virginia Tech, they just got let go. So, but it's tough. But these kids, I think that through the meeting we had and watching film and seeing how they played compared to they did a week ago and sharing both of it. And then coming home to play, and it's senior day, and you know, you want to send your seniors out with a good feel, and there's a lot of motivation that we can utilize to, you know, to get back with it. And our kids were embarrassed, you know, they're embarrassed on Saturday. We all were, and but the score didn't matter to me. We're trying to play catch up. You got to do what you got to do. Is that I didn't think that, you know, we got to play with the assignment, tackle, just fundamentals. We just got to play better. And part of that's, you know, playing some young kids. But still, you know, we got to get them motivated. And the more enthusiasm you have and the harder you play, the better chance you have. And we got down, and they were just physical. I mean, it is what it is. You watched it. They physically got after our tail end, period. And they got a good, like I said, they got a good football team. They've done it to about everybody, so.
Coach, whether it's that game or any other game you coached in, when it gets out of hand early like that, as an offensive coach, where does your mind go from your standpoint? Because, I mean, your game plan, you're going to have to get away from it to catch up.
And I've been kind of going on both sides, though. Like, I spent about half my time practicing defense, the other half on offense. But from an offensive perspective, you can say, well, we're just going to run the ball and, you know, try to, you know, just grind the game out, keep the score down so it don't look so bad. Or you say, hey, we're going to try to win, and we're going to have to, you know, the game plan's out the door, and we're going to have to go try to win. And you can do a little bit of both if you don't get down too quick. But, you know, when they're up, you know, 21 points or whatever, then you have to do some things maybe you didn't want to do. And you know, that part of it, you know, then you're throwing it into, they're going to play soft coverage because they want you to run the ball. And so you get into that deal, and, you know, it's hard to catch it. You know, you see it in the NFL, it's hard to catch up when you get that far down that early. And we had the sad thing is, you know, Quentin never drops the ball, and, you know, he missed the ball, couldn't find it. And then the very next play, we had somebody wide open right down the middle, nobody was there. You know, we score there, you know, maybe it, you know, shifts a little bit. But we had some time to get back in the game early, and we didn't make some plays that we made a week before. And I think we're a real fragile group anyway, because of all the things that happened. Man, we got like 50-some-odd young players. Is we're so fragile, you know, we couldn't have that happen. We hit a couple of those plays, you know, the young kids. You know, and we're playing, you know, they had, I don't know, 22, I think it was. They had 22 kids that are like, that are 22, 23 year old because of the COVID situation. They all came back like Iowa State did. And then we're playing with 18, 19 year olds for the most part. So that does make a difference, you know, experience does. You know, yeah, I'd like to think every one of us get a little smarter as you get older. And, Maybe I'm not, but most people do.
Coach, if you have that situation, a quarterback where Chandler maybe can't go all full 100%, and Max can't go, and obviously Sam, who's the next option?
Probably you are.
I'm not tall enough.
You're not tall enough? We're trying to figure that out right now, to be honest with you. But I think, you know, I've talked to Chandler. Chandler will be ready to go. It's just going to be the practice time, and Max will be ready to go. It's just, you know, the tough thing is they don't get to practice the way. So you try, it's hard to say, you know, the timing we had and all that, you know, with Chandler when he was really raw, it's hard to keep all that if they, you know, not practicing all the time. So, but Chandler came in and talked to me today, and he feels a lot better. And Newfield might be the kid that he played quarterback before. He's done play some receiver for us. That would move, probably move back to quarterback possibly. And that's where we're at. You know, that's what we've been spending most of our time on. It's not so much schemes and all that. It's more about personnel and getting the right personnel on the field and trying to get our best that we have left out there and somehow keep them healthy.
Jerry, I know you talked about it a little bit last week that you know, encouraged Gary to go on to vacation or a beach somewhere, but do you expect him to be back on senior day, or have you talked to him about it?
Oh yeah, that's something I haven't, we've been busy and I haven't said a whole lot to him. And you know, I mean, he's got a lot of great pride in his place and so forth. So, you know, I can't tell you right now, you know, and all those things are his call and his decision. He's been here. He's got a statue. I don't have a statue here. So he'll get to decide what he wants to do there.
Coach, you mentioned, you know, all of these mid-season coaching changes and just the level of disruption that happens when something like that goes on. How do you, in the interim role, stay focused, and how do you keep this team focused on the goals that you've set?
Well, not only that, I also got to keep the coaches focused, because they don't have, let's face it, you don't have jobs. And head coach goes, you don't have jobs either. And usually the head coach coming in, because I've been one of those. Usually every job I've taken has been 1 in 10 the year, and they fire the coach, and then you come in, and you know, it's one of those things where, you know, you get to build it. It's not in the middle of a season where or whatever, when you're in this situation. So this is an entirely different kind of thing. But, you know, go ahead and add it. What's the rest of the question?
Just how do you keep your guys focused when there's so much distraction?
The best thing to do is just kind of like you're doing is talk to them all the time. It's been, you know, I've been basically talking to kids one right after the other, trying to make sure we stay focused, talking to guys that need to step up more as leaders. I talked to our coaches and, you know, hey, you know, this is the best thing you do. We focus in on winning games, and they've done a heck of a job. There's nobody that can say, and everybody knows in the country, check my track record, I'm going to tell it like it is. There's nobody can say that our coaches and sitting around looking for jobs hour after hour after hour. Our coaches have busted their butt for these kids. You know, they want to win for these kids, and they want to do a good job, because a better job they do here right now helps them later on too. But you know, they have done what they need to do. I'm very proud of them, and the kids, again, you're dealing with 18, 19 year old kids. They're up and down, up and down, up and down on things. And, So, we got to get them focused back to where we had them when we played Baylor. And, I think we can do that. You know, I really do. I wouldn't be standing here if I didn't think we could. But I'll know a lot more about the field today, you know, but I felt good Sunday and Monday. You know, hey, you know, we got a lot to play for. It's just, I worry more, to be honest with you, just who we're going to be able to play, the health-wise. Certainly the secondary, too.
Jared, when this stint is over, it's for you as interim head coach. Has this made you want to get back into on-field coaching, or do you enjoy the role you're in and want to stick to kind of something that you were doing before you did that?
That's an interesting question. I don't know how many people are going to give a guy that's 60-year-old that has epilepsy or has epilepsy and has had cancer twice and so forth and an opportunity. Do I think I could coach again? Yeah. You know, it's a totally different time. I've been healthy for 4 years, whole different situation. I've got to go to 3 or 4 different programs and be able to check out how they do it and how you know, I'd still be coaching if I'd done it a little bit different, but I only knew it one way. You know, I played under Coach Franchelli. I don't know if y'all know that, but I did. So I only know it one way. You know what he's like. Work a deal and so forth. So we've all been trained the same way at UPA. And so I've been able to go around and see other ways to do it. And people are doing it a lot different, where they got their coordinators and then, you know, they're more CEO type people and things of that nature. So I don't, you know, am I gonna still be involved in football? Yes. What capacity? You know, whatever capacity that I can be in, you know, and I've been fortunate to have had 3 or 4 offers last year to leave here, and I chose to stay here. I love Texas, and I bought land here in Texas. I won't be selling that. About whether I do something somewhere outside or whatever, I'll come back to Fort Worth in Texas. But, you know, just have to see. But I think, you know, I have an opportunity and so forth somewhere, and I just don't know what it'd be, and I don't really care. I just want to be a part of, I want to be part of the game. I mean, that's all I've known, and it's still fun to me, and it's still I love the kids. I mean, it isn't like they are nowadays where you got people making $5 million or $10 million, whatever, $10 million for 10 years. You got LZ or more than that, even. I work for $250 a month. I started off in high school coaching Mike Gundy. I mean, I wouldn't, so I'm in it for the kids, and plus it keeps you young. I mean, my daddy retired at 65 and died at 65. I ain't ever retiring, I'll tell you that. So, and I think the more busy you keep, the younger you stay. So, and I like being around young people. They make me younger. So,
Coach, you have to mention it to your players, or they're aware with the 2 games you have left, what's still out there for them if they can win out?
Sure. And, I think they know that, but they'll get more, educated more today even, but you just got to keep talking about it. And that repetition, you just got to keep talking about, you got to do this, you got to do this, you got to do this. We came in special teams, and I'm out here demonstrating stuff, the fundamental stuff that they need to do. I said, you got to do this, you got to take this step, you got to do that. It's right there, look at the film, I don't lie to you. So listen to what we're trying to tell you. Listen. And we'll listen to you. But we got to learn to listen, and get it transferred to the field. And we did lie at the first in the Baylor game. And this game, I think they tried to listen, but we had more guys coming in and out of the game and trying to get people in special teams. It was just, as wild as the Baylor game was, on the winning note, this is a wild game. On the losing note, it just, it's been kind of wild, really. It's been unique, but it's been good. I mean, it's a great challenge. I mean, I've never been in this position. Not many people are, so it's just another thing that I can say I did, I guess.
Coach, just real fast, your take on Kansas. What have you seen from them early on? I know they've got a new coach.
I know that coach, and he won about everything he could at Whitewater. Got tired. He probably got bored of winning championships, I guess. And then he went to Buffalo, where nobody wins at Buffalo, and he won at Buffalo. My quarterback coach, Jimmy Sobrowski, coached for me at Minnesota. And he's got a good staff, great hire by KU. Smart, off the charts, smart guy. You watch, he'll get it back to where, Mangino had it, and competing and doing all those things. It won't be long. It won't take him long. You have to look at what he did at Buffalo. I don't know how many years it took at Buffalo. Usually takes about 3 years, 3 or 4 years, But right now he's got him on a faster track than I ever thought he could. And offensively, their quarterbacks, whichever one they played, have both played well, and they're a problem. And you score that many points against Texas, and you beat Texas at their place, you're doing something right. And he's brought a new mentality to that program and to that team. He don't put up with a lot of stuff. Disciplined guy. You can tell they're coached, no disrespect to anybody, but they're coached better. They're coached better, their technique's better. They're just a lot better football team than what they were a year ago. There's no comparison. They're on the right track. I can tell you from taking over a program to what they're doing exactly what they need to do. And so I think you'll see a team that, it's going to be a battle. I don't think there's any question about that. And I think you'll see a team that's going to be on the rise for the next, several years.
Final question for Coach? Thank you.
You guys have a great day.
Thanks.